found a space to name our own. There ain't no need to fret or fuss. We've got all the strength we need in the shape of us. In the shape of us. In the shape of us. And I know you've had it tough. The road's been bumpy and rough. But say goodbye to a world that you once knew. I have every faith in me and you.
So I just wanted to let you know how excited I am. I woke up extremely early this morning. Couldn't sleep anymore, staring at the ceiling, just thinking about our future together and all the great life we're gonna have together. I hope today was relaxing and not stressful for you. I hope both the dogs, the reason we ended up meeting, I hope both of them are enjoying themselves at the boarding facility, the pet hotels. It'll be nice to, once the commotion from all the wedding is over, to have our family together and get settled in. And realistically, I love you for so many reasons. But really, what it comes down to is, you're the only person I want to see when I go to sleep, and you're the only person I want to wake up to every morning.
So we met on this wonderful walk, these beautiful walks that we had almost every day with our wonderful dogs, and from that developed this wonderful relationship that turned into a wonderful love. And now we get to spend the rest of our lives together. And I'm so excited to have you as my partner and best friend. And just to have this journey with you. This is going to be a wonderful life. We've got so much to look forward to. And I know with you by my side, it's going to be a wild and fun and wonderful, loving ride. I love you, and I can't wait until we're married.
Forever could never be long enough for me to feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted in my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Together could never be close enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you, and you're beautiful. Now that the wait is over, love has finally showed her my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. promise me you'll always be happy by my side. I promise to sing to you when all the music dies.
Today's been a whirlwind. I mean, there's been all kinds of things that have gone right, but probably more things that have gone wrong that probably nobody
will ever know.
But that's okay, because I think a lot of them made for funny stories that we'll probably have for years to come.
And it's now raining, and it didn't rain the whole day, which was awesome, except for when it wasn't supposed to, so it was good. And
yeah, I mean, they say it's good luck to rain on your wedding day.
So we should be in good shape.
Yep, it's rained a few times today. Now everybody's here at the reception.
So thankful for all our family and friends that have come near and far to be with us and to celebrate with us. And
it's very overwhelming, the love that everybody's shown us, and how excited everybody is for us.
People taking care of us and taking care of things that we didn't even know we were going to need, and just feeling the love and the
People just all day long, you know, making sure that everything we need is taken care of, or you know, the best it can be. You know, I think after this we're gonna take a little bit of a breath and take a break for a second before moving to the next phase, which I think once all the stuff in the wedding calms down, we've sent everybody thank you cards and all of that.
You go on a honeymoon.
We get settled, and once we get back from the honeymoon, I think then we'll worry about the next phase. But for right now, I think we're just enjoying
each other and enjoy being free of any kind of deadlines and just be able to have fun and go and do what we want to on the weekends and lay on the couch and watch our TV shows again and just relax for a while.
That'll be great.
Yes.
On a night like this, I could fall in love. I could fall in love with you. Thank you.
may be seated. On behalf of Lisa and Brian, it is my privilege to say a personal word of greeting and welcome to everyone. Each of you here is special in Lisa and Brian's hearts and lives. They are honored that you are here to share in this worship service, celebrating and consecrating their marriage. We are gathered here in the presence of God to share in the joy and celebration as Lisa and Brian are united in Christian marriage. In his providential wisdom, care, and love, God has brought them together to this place and time to commit their lives to each other and to God. Lisa and Brian, our presence here as family and friends is an affirmation of our love for both of you as you promise to face the future together. You have had the excitement of dating, falling in love, and being engaged, and now the day you've planned for, you've dreamed about, and worked toward has arrived, your wedding day. Who shares in this decision for Lisa to be married to Brian? Let us pray. God, you are the creator of love. You loved us before we could ever love you. Thank you for bringing Lisa and Brian together. Continue to deepen their love. Bless them as they make public the commitment already made in their hearts to love each other for the rest of their lives. Grant them a spiritual purpose in life. May they seek first your kingdom. May they not expect perfection in each other that belongs only to you. Give them tasks that will bless them and develop their character as they walk together. Give them enough tears to keep them tender, enough success to remind them that they walk with you, enough joy that they would share it with others. May they never take each other for granted. May their love, like your love, be unconditional and eternal. In the wonderful name of Jesus, we ask this. Amen. In the Bible, we read that love is patient and kind, does not envy, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not irritable, does not seek its own ways, it is not easily provoked, thinks that the best of each other, does not rejoice in wrong, but rejoices in right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. Love is trying when you don't want to, staying in when it would be easier to walk away. Doing what is right, even as temptation whispers to do wrong. Love is doing what is good rather than what is easy or self-centered. Love is forgiving those who have wronged you and who may do it again. Love is an act of the will, not just feelings. Now abides faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Marriage is ordained by God. It is the highest of all relationships on earth. It was honored by Jesus as he performed his first miracle of changing water into wine at the wedding celebration. His most cherished description of the church was his bride, for which he gave his life. In the book of Ephesians, the Bible says, "Husbands, love your wife as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her. Be subject to one another out of reverence for Christ. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined his wife. The two shall become one." Marriage are not made in heaven. They come in kits and must be put together here on earth. Love is not what makes the world go round. It makes the ride worthwhile. Through your life together, you will laugh and hurt. Together, you will feel all of life's ups and downs. You will learn and grow through trial and error. These lessons will show you the meaning of true love, agape love, and the difference between love that lasts and one that just gives up. To love someone means having a genuine concern for them more than for yourself, being able to sense that something is wrong without being told. It is understanding the other partner's problems, moods, and hang-ups, and accepting all of them, even if you don't quite understand. It is excusing their faults because you know that their good points far outweigh their bad ones. Love is sharing the amusing times and the serious times. It is doing things together, yet leaving room for each other to grow as an individual. Love is always being there for each other, with a shoulder to cry on, to give support when confidence levels are low, to give helpful advice when it is asked for, to know when to be silent and just listen, or to give cheerful words of hope and encouragement. You will encourage each other's dreams and forgive each other's faults. You will succeed together and climb the mountain of your hopes together. You will face together each failure and discover the strength to go on and grow closer. Through this opportunity called marriage, you will become as one, creating a relationship that will grow into an infinite love like God's love for us. Brian, do you choose Lisa as your partner in marriage? Will you love her as you build your life together? Will you be honest with her and trust her? When disagreements come, will you use them to grow closer to her? Will you do all within your power to make your relationship growing and loving as long as you both shall live? And Lisa, do you choose Brian as your partner in marriage? Will you love him as you build your life together? Will you be honest with him and trust him? When disagreements come, will you use them to grow closer to him? Will you do all within your power to make your relationship growing and loving as long as you both shall live? The repeating of vows requires about 30 seconds, but keeping them is the work of a lifetime. To keep a vow means so much more than not just breaking them, but to devote the rest of your lives discovering what the vows mean, and knowing the feeling of freedom and security that keeping them provides and ensures. Face one another and join hands and hearts as you repeat your vows. I, Brian, take you, Lisa.
I, Brian, take you, Lisa.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And I promise before God.
And I promise before God.
And these witnesses.
And these witnesses.
To be a loving and faithful husband.
To be a loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Repeat after me, Lisa. Lisa, I, Lisa, take you, Brian.
I, Lisa, take you, Brian.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
And I promise before God.
For God
and these witnesses,
and these witnesses,
to be a loving and faithful wife,
to be a loving and faithful wife,
in plenty and in want,
in plenty and in want,
in joy and in sorrow,
in joy and in sorrow,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
to love and to cherish,
as long as we both shall live,
as long as we both shall live.
Down through history, rings have symbolized completeness and limitless devotion. Being made of precious metals indicates the pricelessness of your love. They serve as an outward reminder of your inward love. These rings tell the world that you are committed to each other, faithful to your vows, and that you will work so that this loving relationship, like a circle, will have no end. Brian, will you take the ring? Place this ring on Lisa's finger and repeat after me. Lisa, I give you this ring.
Lisa, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I will become.
And all that I will become.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Lisa, you take the ring. Place the ring on Brian's finger and repeat after me. Brian, I give you this ring.
Brian, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I will become.
All that I will become.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Brian and Lisa, at these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist, but will be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand could never be separated and poured again into the individual containers, so will your marriage be united as one for all the days to come. Let us pray. Loving God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing Lisa and Brian together in your marvelous providential wisdom, for joining their hearts and lives as one in Christian marriage. In this first moments of their marriage, they have acknowledged your presence, importance in your lives together. We pray that they will continue to draw upon your strength and resources throughout their lives. When they laugh for joy, may they give you praise for life. When they face sorrow, may they find comfort in you and each other. May their dreams be your will for them, their hopes your plans for them. With each challenge they face, may they grow in grace, faith, and love. Make this marriage a channel of blessing, not only to them, but for others who will be touched by their lives. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Lisa and Brian, having pledged your faith in the love to each other and having expressed your commitment before God in this fellowship of this Christian community and having declared your love by giving and receiving of rings, acting in authority given to me as a minister of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and looking to God for his continual approval and blessing, I pronounce that you are husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Brian, you may kiss your bride. Now, come here, Emma. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great joy and honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Brian Foley.
baby. It's been a long day, baby. Things ain't been going my way, you know I need you here. You clear my mind all the time. And baby, the way you move me, it's crazy.
Then we have our flower girls and ring bearer. Please welcome Ella Nunez, Matthew Hardigree, and Jack Hardigree. Right here, there they are. Everybody's looking great. Then, ladies and gentlemen, we have our bridesmaids and groomsmen. Please welcome Ann Clemenson Brown, and she's escorted by Mr. David Cox. Then please welcome Jennifer Cummings, and she's escorted by Mr. Sean Dobbs. Then please welcome Jody Cummings, and she's escorted by Mr. Jeff Weaver. Then please welcome Michelle Hardigree and John Hardigree. Then welcome please Kelly Syed and Mr. Reese Heil. Then, ladies and gentlemen, we have the maid of honor and best man. The maid of honor is a great friend, Miss Kim Steen, and the best man is the brother of the groom, Mr. Jeff Foley. Put your hands together. Help them out a little bit.
Let's go. Make no excuses now. I'm talking baby now. I'm talking
baby. If everyone would please rise, ladies and gentlemen, please stand. Put your hands together a little bit, ladies and gentlemen. Here they are, the bride and groom, Lisa and Brian Foley. Mr. and Mrs. Brian Foley, here they come. Ladies and gentlemen, celebrating your 1 hour wedding anniversary. Give them a big round of applause. Aren't they doing great? Ladies and gentlemen, the bride and groom have elected to go into their first dance. This is a great song. It's titled The Shape of Us.
Found a space to name our own. There ain't no need to fret or fuss. We've got all the strength we need in the shape of us. In the shape of us. In the shape of us. And I know you've had it tough. The road's been bumpy and rough. But say goodbye to a world that you once knew. I have every faith in me and you. Hold my hand. Hold my hand. I never felt quite so at home. And your sweet caress is the best I've known. And now that I've proved to you that I'm worthy of your trust, let us build a world in the shape of us. In the shape of us. In the shape of us. Hold my hand. Hold my heart.
Here we have, ladies and gentlemen, the bride. This time, folks, we'd like to invite you to please take your places. We're going to get the meal underway. Give another nice round of applause.
All right, for those of you who don't know, I'm Jeff Foley, the younger, better-looking brother. First, I'd like to thank Linda and your noise on here. I'd like to thank Henry for raising such an amazing, beautiful daughter.
Aww.
And so, the wise person once told me that magic happens at the most unexpected moments, but I just kind of disagree. Today has been planned for months now, and it's full of magic. Growing up with my brother, I've never seen him happier than he is today. And I really don't think I've ever seen Lisa without a smile on her face when she's with my brother. Now this magic makes you happy is love. Now love, however, isn't always simple. You will fight and disagree, but as long as you love each other, the magic will never die. May the rest of your lives be filled with magic alone. Love you.
Aww.
Lisa and I are known as phone friends because we spend hours and hours on the phone. Hours. We'll watch TV and talk about nothing. Or talk about lots of things. We talk about our dreams and our hopes and failures and all sorts of good stuff, right? Anyway, I'm glad that this dream is coming true.
Yeah.
Oh, that's
Okay, good show.
Yeah.
No, you don't. I was just
Lisa.
Smaller.
Yes. Yes. Do it. Do it. Oh, Bill.
When life leaves you high and dry, I'll be at your door tonight. If you need help, if you need help, I'll shut down the city lights. I'll lie, cheat, I'll beg and bribe to make you well, to make you well. When enemies are at your door, I'll carry you away from more. If you need help, if you need help, your hope dangling by a string, I'll share in your suffering to make you well, to make you well. Give me reasons to believe that you would do the same for me, and I would do it for you. You're gone, gone, gone. When you fall like a statue, I'm gonna be there to catch you, put you on your feet, you on your feet. And if your well is empty, not a thing will prevent me. Tell me what you need, what do you need? I surrender honestly. I will do it for you.
For you.
Baby, I'm not moving on. I'll love you long after you're gone.
For you.
For you. You will never sleep alone. I'll love you long after you're gone. And long after you're gone, gone, gone. You're my backbone. You're my cornerstone. You're my crutch when my legs stop moving. You're my head start, you're my rugged heart. You're the pulse that I've always needed. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Like a drum, baby, don't stop beating. Like a drum, my heart never stops beating. For you. You're gone. Like a drum, my heart never stops beating for you. And long after you're gone, 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 I'll love you long after you're gone, gone, gone.
Everybody that doesn't know me, I'm Brian. I'm not Brian. Rashawn. Brian's a really good friend. Family.
Brother. He's a brother.
I'm a girl. Anyways, I just want to say you guys are perfect. Couldn't ask for a best friend. You guys have a great relationship, and you guys already do. Appreciate both of you. I love you both.
Very nice, Sean. Very nice, sir. All right, we need single gentlemen that are up here. Is this all the single guys? Brian, just do me a favor. Make sure, just look the room over. Make sure there's no other single gentlemen here. All right, down on one kneecap, if you would, Brian, the way that you proposed to her, I'm sure. This time we're gonna go ahead and escort Lisa right off to the side. Lisa, I'm sorry, it just became gentleman's night out. Right over here, sweetheart, I'm gonna give you a bouquet. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the bride of Broadway. This is an incredible dress. No, this is an incredible dress. You are so good. All right, it's going over his right shoulder on the count of three. I need a little audience participation if you would. Don't do anything, Brian, until I tell you. Nice and slow, Brian. We're going to do it like this. Before he actually does. Brian. Ready, Brian? Here we go. One, two, three. Good job. Don't they make like candy necklaces or something instead? I mean, it just doesn't seem right. But that, no, give them a little round of applause, guys. Like, you're faster than all those other guys. All right. Single girls, single ladies. Come on, girls. What? Single, good looking, attractive females. Go ahead and raise your hand, girls. Raise your hand for single. It's nothing that you want to be proud of for single for that. There's only one bride in the room, but there's a lot of future brides. All right, it's a sweetheart. Look around, turn around real quick. Make sure none of these girls are single over here. Oh, what's that, a photo bomb? Photo? single girls. All the married girls are going, another one. All right, on the count of three. We're going to do it in Spanish. Ready? Uno, dos, tres.
Share them.